Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're going to see polar opposites in terms of philosophies in this game. And when you want to pass the ball all the time, move quickly, sometimes facing a team that's based in a ground-oriented time-of-possession attack can be very frustrating. You get antsy. You get too eager to make plays. Can they maintain their concentration if they don't get the ball as often as they're used to? That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Biggest stadium around, but when the fans get it going here, it's as raucous as they come. Football is on the way. And now it's time for the coin toss. And it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. We'll see how these two teams play in this game as they prepare for the opening kickoff. Kidd from the three. Tackle at the 21. Georgia Tech's a team and a program that year in, year out's got 1,000-yard rushers. Sometimes they've got two, and they've got that huge offensive line. And, you know, you get too worried about them, and sometimes you can overlook the fact they can throw the ball.
It's going to be tough today for this defense. I think they're going to have to take some chances and load this line of scrimmage. And, you know, as a play caller for this offense, when you have such a gifted running back, it opens up every aspect of the offense. I mean, the play action pass with this running game, you get those linebackers and safeties coming up close to the line of scrimmage. It's a great time to really open up and show what you can do as a complete offense. It'll be a challenge.
Second down at 14. Ball on the 17-yard line.
Hey, watch that. Check
mic 54. Red 2. He's tackled right around the 30.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. Third down.
Down he goes, around the 39-yard line.
There's a reason why defenses hate playing against teams that run the option well. It's so unpredictable. That time they couldn't defend it properly, and they gave up a first down.
Pitch out, got the corner. He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? You better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
First and 10. Ball on the 43. Room around the corner. Nice run there as they work the outside. Knocked out of bounds around the 19-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 19. Taken down at the 17-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards.
Second and eight. This is the eighth play of this drive.
Roger, Roger. Hey, watch that, watch that. Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
The 10. He's knocked out of bounds at the 6. So the option play gets him big yards right there.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing how sometimes this guy is able to find a hole and get through it.
From the 6-yard line, it's first down. Touchdown, Tech. The extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Time to go to the Little Apple in Manhattan. And for Kansas State, they've dropped 2 straight. Memphis gets the win by 7.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Georgia Tech is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Nearly intercepted.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid fundamental pass defense.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 24. They hand it off. Brought down right around the 24-yard line.
No gain.
You ain't going nowhere.
Watch that, watch that. Check
Mike 54. Easy, easy. Clear, clear, clear.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Awaits the snap. Tries to get around the corner. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
They get nice yardage on that run.
That brings them second and 5.
It's second and 5 here. Ball on the 47. Georgia Tech up 7 points.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. So the option keeper will get him a first down.
This is a very well-executed option play. The blocking was there, and the quarterback made the correct decision to keep it himself and get the first down.
They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line. Douglas picks up 2 yards with a carry. From the 38-yard line, it's second down.
There's some daylight.
He makes his way to about the 22. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
It. He's got the corner, and they make the stop at the 14.
That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Oh, Folks, that's the end of quarter number one, and we got a pretty good ball game on our hands so far. 7-0, Georgia Tech. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. Georgia Tech is up a score.
Dog four.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
First down. Defense trying to prevent any more damage. First and goal inside the five. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense.
Touchdown, Georgia Tech.
Converts the extra point. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese,
time to get you up to date on what's going on in Houston. And for Louisiana Tech, they're struggling to take control of this game. Patrick's command of the passing game is impressive. He's already tossed two touchdown passes. Rice leads it 14-7.
14-0 in this one, Reese. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line. He's tackled at the 25. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. And he's tackled at the 23-yard line.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
It's 2nd and 12. Ball on the 23-yard line. Gives it to the back. Tackle made at about the 33-yard line. Throws a strike over the middle. Tackle at the 44-yard line.
Great effort here by the wideout to secure the ball and pick up some extra yardage.
Quick throw to the tight end.
Call it a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
And he's taken down around the 47-yard line.
The defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Now he's scrambling, and he's sacked.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Fuller is back to receive. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
From their own 32-yard line. 2nd down.
Black 5, yellow 3.
Lost the ball, fumble, and it's scooped up by the running back, and he's stopped behind the line.
Well, this is the risk you take when you run the option. It has great potential for big yards, but it's got to be executed carefully.
The Hoosiers taking their first time out of the half. It's third and long. Ball on the 21.
Don't let him free. Don't let him free. Play that tight end.
Black five. Black five. Orange three.
Indiana will have one timeout remaining. Mitchell to punt. McKinney fields it at the 50. Brought down at the 38-yard line. Pretty good job by the return man there. We're about set to start things up again. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to slide.
Gain of five on the play. That'll make it second and four.
Check 31, check 31.
Fires quick out to the receiver and he can't make the grab.
Terrific coverage. And when you clog up passing lanes like that, you can force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. And they get the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. It's not that often, Kirk, we see a team that plays this well when their star player isn't playing well. Now, Douglas's stats line, well, as we approach halftime, nowhere near what we expected.
Well, I'm sure he's not too concerned about his individual performance up to this point because the team is playing so well. This is actually, I think, a testament to just how good this football team is and how well they're coached. To have your star player not playing his best and yet to still have the lead, getting ready still for half of football to go.
From their own 21-yard line, second down.
Red two.
Played a half. The Yellow Jackets lead 14-0. Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. McKinney from the two. They'll bring him down at the 23. Georgia Tech's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Gets it. He's in space. That's a great tackle at the 41-yard line.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Easy!
O'Neal gets the ball. Good outside run there.
That makes it second and six.
He's tackled at the 44. To the senior, and down he goes
around the 22-yard line.
A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
Tighten up, tighten up.
Easy, easy. Flare, flare. Go.
They bring him down in the backfield. The 23-yard line. Second down. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set, and the defense counters with their dime look. Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down at the 11.
That makes it first and 10.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Throws and it's incomplete.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
From the 11-yard line, it's second down. He fights forward to about the 10. Zips it to the back, and he's level at the 8-yard line. A couple of yards that time on the screen.
This was just a little dump-off pass to the halfback, but it was very well defended, keeping them from moving the ball very far downfield.
So it's fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. It's up. Tough break there for the kicking team.
This guy needs to go back over his mechanics. Something seems to be off in his footwork, and that's not a good thing for a kicker. Sometimes it is very hard to correct.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field.
I smell fear in that offense.
And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. He's out to the 30. He makes his way out to about the 35. He makes his way to about the 45.
That brings him second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
Roger, Roger! Hey, watch that, watch that. Check Mike 54. Mike 54.
And now he pitches it. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
from their own 48-yard line. It's second down.
Black five, black five.
Brought down right around the 48-yard line. Guns it right side. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. And this play is number 8 on the drive. He takes it right side for a good gain. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Runs outside for a nice game. This is the 10th play of this drive. They'll bring him down right around the 20.
That is a loss of 3 yards.
So at the end of the third quarter, the Yellow Jackets lead 14-0. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. Gets out to around the 9. We're at the 12th play of the drive.
Seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, Yellow Jackets. PAT. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
Right, playing ball in Houston. We've been watching this thing all day long. The Bulldogs unleash their aerial assault and find pay dirt for a touchdown. The Owls have the lead by 13.
I don't expect that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Indiana's had a really hard time establishing any kind of rhythm on offense today.
Yeah, and we're so used to seeing that from them. They might want to go back and look at this film and try to study to see what they didn't do well, because this is not the type of offense you'd expect to see from these guys.
They come out on an empty backfield. He's wrapped up for the sack.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
So the sack makes this a second and long. He's scrambling. And they make the stop
right around the 24-yard line.
Three and 15.
fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And he's tackled around the 40-yard line.
This receiver showed soft hands and hung on for the first down. And if I'm not mistaken, the defense sent their corner on a blitz. If he doesn't get to the quarterback, the numbers are in favor of the offense, just like we saw.
And they got it. They've been all over this quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
So it's second down and 13 yards to go following that quarterback sack. Just under three to go in regulation. Tackle made around the 46-yard line.
Murray brings him down at the 46-yard line. That'll bring up third and four.
Hey, watch that, watch that. Check Mike 54.
Easy, easy. Easy.
Pulls it in and stopped in his tracks with that tackle. And once again, the coaches decided to go for it on fourth down. They're all tied in on the line here on fourth and short. He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards.
Kill, kill, kill.
First and 10.
Fires incomplete. He was looking for the tight end. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Going long. And he's taken down around the 18-yard line. They need to find a way to get points this trip in the red zone. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. And this is the 12th play of the drive. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Tackle at the nine. Fourth down again, and let's see if the third time's the charm as they try and put an end to this drive. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Nice run up the middle.
Gain of five on the play. That makes it first and goal.
He tackles him for a loss.
He wasn't decisive at all on that option. And once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
The Hoosiers will use their first time out of the half. This is the 16th play of this drive. They'll give it off here. He's tackled around the 4-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
This junior corner's been progressively improving his run defense. He's better at diagnosing those plays now. He knows how to bring a guy down.
So here we go. It's third and goal from the 3-yard line. And they'll get him in the backfield. Bring him down. Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
He's to the 20. Makes it out to about the 26.
From their own 26-yard line, it's first down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback, take a knee. And that should do it, our final tally in this one. 21-0, Yellow Jackets. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.